Hello and welcome to the stream, Making Songbringer. This is day 234. And today I'm going to be working on the Steam page. So last week, got the alpha version released, alpha video done, screenshots are looking good. And today I'm just going to be making more art and description, a little better description for more concise description for this Steam page. So if anybody, I'll post a link. What's up, Pedro? PETA, welcome you guys. How do I say hello in Portuguese? I know how to say ciao, bello. What's up, Marza? Yo, you guys. So, yeah, I'm working on the Steam page right now, but it's not going to be live because, hola? Or is it hola? Hola. Is that close? Well, yeah, so I'm working on the, let's see, here's the link. But it's not going to be live. So what I'm doing here to edit, you won't actually see on this page right now. But I'm working on that. So what I did is, because the way Steam works is it's kind of a confidential back end or whatever. Nice. Right on. I got it right. So you can't... I don't think I can share a live stream of working on the back end of Steam. So what I've done is I've just saved out an HTML file to my desktop of this Songbringer page, and I'm just going to work on it. So I'm on this section right here, the About the Game. Yeah, it says it on yours or mine. Oh, yeah, it says it on yours. This one I'm working on. I logged out and made sure to do a screen that way. All right, so I like this graphic here that I've created. I like this is pretty cool, right? All three characters, not the fourth character, but and then I've started rewriting the description to be kind of more from the perspective of like introducing you to the character sooner. So you talks about Rock and Jib, his friend, and stuff. So I think the next picture I want is of Rock picking up the sword. Well, yeah, I guess that would work. What's up, Byron Koken? It's marketing day today. I'm working on the Steam page right now, just kind of working on the descriptions here and graphics to go with it. And then once I'm finished with it, this will probably take another 3 to 4 hours to get this all, you know, graphically looking better. And then I think the last thing to do for this Songbringer page is to finally post an update. So there'll be like an update right here. What's up, ZTwitch? What's offline? Is the stream already offline? Looks fine. All right, so... actually, I like this. Okay, I got an idea for which screenshot to use. There's this. I like this cool screenshot. Yeah, there. This is a really good one to use right there. I think this is a pretty sweet shot. What's up, Artemis? What resources would I recommend for learning OpenGL? Let me give you a couple cool ones. I recommend two things. There's shaderific.com. It's great for learning OpenGL. And ShaderToy. ShaderToy.com. And then, of course, just read the documentation. Read everything on Shaderific.com. You know, do tutorials. Get other, you know, like OpenGL. Open. What's the FL GL? Oh, GLFW. Yeah, you can get this library right here. This is a great library to get cross-platform for opening Windows. And I wrote a sample project too. GitHub, NatWeese, GLFW test. So this will like print out like a little triangle. Some stuff to check out. Right, so this first scene, when I export it, it becomes221 tall, but before it's 78 tall. So 78 pixels is a pretty good height, or less. So I want to do about 78 pixels high. Or I guess width is pretty important too. This thing is 217 wide. So if I were to grab like a 217 pixels or so, oh, this is oh yeah. So I gotta shrink these down. These were the 1080p versions. All right, so now I want it to be 217. By 78 if possible. So if this was cropped. So I'm gonna play with this. So what I'm trying to do is create some graphics that flow really well on this Steam page. So that means they kind of need to have a dark blue background, and they kind of need to fade into it so that they feel like they're part of the text a little more. Like even this one, I did a fade on the edges to kind of give it to the feeling that it's part of the text rather than this screenshot you're just looking at. So that's the goal for this little shot here. Turn that into something more flowing with text. Man, ever since I upgraded it. El Capitan, Photoshop is broken for its. I can't. When I do this zoom, it doesn't show the zoom anymore. Oh, wait, no, it does now. Oh, it just takes a really long time for it to kick in. Anyways, totally blaming El Capitan on that one. So I want these gargoyles to be part of this. So I'm selecting them all and bringing them onto their own layer. This is probably kind of a backwards way of doing this, but I want this shot to have the shadows and all the dynamic parts of the image. But not a lot of the background. So a lot of the cliff is gonna kind of get to be partially transparent or fully transparent. Here we go, we got that guy out. Would it? I don't know. Magic wand. Well, I guess so. But not always like 100%. Guess I can do it this way for at least the gargoyle part. Yeah, that was easier for sure. Thanks, good suggestion, Pedro. Yeah, that was like half the time right there. All right, cool. And let me call this one this is the Steam Scene 3. And I need the background blue color so I can know what I'm working with. There. Okay, so with the remaining bits of this, a lot of this is going to fade out. Except for the character, of course. Both the characters, yeah. We got to get these guys on their own layer. Yeah, so sometimes art is just a little time consuming. I guess it depends on how you're doing it. I could have reconstructed this whole scene from sprites, but everything wouldn't have all the dynamic shadows and everything, so I think it's just faster to do it this way. It's because I'm creating such a custom graphic here that it's taking so much time. Why would you look at that? Awesome. I'm glad that works. Okay, so I'm gonna make a layer of that. And now we're ready to do whatever the heck we want. Like I could just change this background like this. In fact, that kind of looks cool. If I made that all the way off, but I don't want it all the way off. Maybe something like that. I could even do something simple like doing a layer mask. What's up, Coin? Yeah, right. It just has a nice little feel. It'll fit in a lot better with this blue background. But I think it could be even better with a little bit of love here with the gradient. Like one of these diamondy gradients. Yeah, exactly. That's freaking awesome. All right, maybe more like that though. Yeah, okay, cool. Let's see how that looks. So I'm gonna export this guy just like that. I know it looks like you can barely see it here, but once we put it in the Steam store, it'll look a lot more right. And look at that, it's only 29K. Cool, we got scene three, and now let's throw it into this HTML. This is the HTML I just copied off of the Steam website, so I can work with this rather than having to deal with their actual interface is really slow, and it's also confidential, so I can't really work on it with a live stream. I'm thinking right here is where. You get a BR image and then a new H2. I'm just mimicking exactly how their HTML works too, so I hopefully don't have to deal with anything once I'm ready to go put it on Steam officially. Nice, right on. Cool, man, good for you. Yeah, I read your book. The first chapter or whatever it is. It's cool. I love how he like took the power from the lights and sounds like a really cool character. I love all the nanites. What's up, Chain Revenge? Okay, and let's see how that looks. So I want the very edge of, I wish I could do two layer masks because I want to do another layer mask right on the bottom. I guess I can. So if I copy this whole layer mask and just make it a new layer. Now I can't do that. Oh man. Cool, man. Right on. Yeah, I was wondering about the armor and everything. Okay, so the effect I'm trying to go for is I want the background to fade out at the very top and the very bottom and do this whole diamond shape. So I need to, I guess I need to just recreate it. Or can I get this to work? Why didn't this? Wait, maybe I did Control C. Oh, there we go. Okay. Nice. Right on. Yeah, I haven't read that chapter, but yeah, it's cool, man. Okay, so we'll do another gradient. Like this. We want it to be black and white. All the way around. What? Come on, come on. Hey, no. Oh my God. Oh yeah, okay. This thing is hard to work with, but I basically just want to reverse this. Here, reverse. Come on. There. Okay, so now I just want to go 50%. No. How do I blend these two layers together perfectly? 50% each? Nah, what I mean to do is gradient like this, but the white part is fully transparent. No. Okay, so the white part needs to be black. Yeah, like that. Damn, man. Okay, so if I take this whole thing and make this, that. It's a little better. That's even better though. I don't know if I like that. Yeah, I like a little bit more of this reflection showing. Yeah, man. Then we can copy this layer for. Actually, let's just make this whole layer give its own layer mask. And then we'll do a single gradient. That. And I guess these guys can go down a little bit in their opacity. Yeah, a little bit. Maybe 90, 92%. Okay, let's check that out. Oh, sorry. I reset the chat window. Okay, one more line or two on this bottom bit. Not that one. This one. Yeah. So it's very bottom. Needs to be black. Yeah, that's a little better. Cool. Awesome. All right. Okay, I think we can live with that. Hey, what's up, Emma? What up, dude? Cool. Yeah, I like this. This graphic's pretty cool. I might switch the protagonist and procedurally generated. Oh, man. This is an old description. I have a newer description I wrote. Well, I'm just going to focus on the graphics. So if I were to do a graphic for, I like this graphic for procedural. This graphic's pretty cool for introducing the hero. So what graphic would work good for? I could do one for item crafting or secrets. Or maybe this is enough graphics. Yeah, right? Yeah. God, I wish I could get. Maybe I should just. Hold on. Wow, yeah, wait, you know what? I could. Because I can't go to partner.stream. Can't go to the Steamworks right now on the live stream. So, wait, what if I do this? What if I just hide the window for a second? I go like this. Can I do that? Yeah, I think I can get away with this. One sec, I'll be right back. Just go into partner.steam games to see if it works. And it was like giving an error. It's like, oh man, what? Still an error with the network. No love. Huh. Well, that didn't work. All right. Well, never mind. I guess I'll just stick with this. But it has way better text, so I'll just focus on the graphics for now. Yeah, you have to sign a confidentiality agreement to use Steam. And then on the very bottom of when you log into the partner website, at the very bottom of every page it says this is confidential, you can't share it, blah blah blah. So yeah, I just think I don't think I can actually share that on the stream. So I guess we're gonna have to work with this old text. But just make some cool graphics, and then later, I'll update it all with the new graphics. So, the ship would probably be a cool thing to see on this story section. Let's do a ship graphic. I have kind of a cool one from the Kickstarter. See if I can work with that one. I think it's Kickstarter. This one? Story? No. Where'd it go? Where? Maybe it's here. Huh. No, why is that? Ah, oh, here finally it is. PC Master Race, yeah. Is this a ping file? Or did they make it? No, they made it a JPEG. God damn it. Right, screw it. There's gotta be another one. Songbringer trailers intro. Man, that sucks. Are you sure they got the message or? See what I mean? I want to show this whole ship, but none of these are the whole ship. Hello, Limpinzan, what's up? What was that one called? I wish it had a name. Wow. It's crazy. Yeah, you know what? I just might as well just show the whole ship anyways. I don't really need the background as much if I'm gonna be having Oh, making art. This is what making art's like sometimes. This is what it takes. This time it takes me hours to freaking work on a Steam page or a website or whatever. I just keep on making so many little changes to the art. So yeah, let's do a new image with the ship. Could have just used this image the whole time. All right, yeah, let's save this as Hello, Hello Wells. Let's call this one Steam Scene 5 or so. And I want to take this background. Do the same kind of thing with two gradients. Sounds awesome. Pima, yeah, it's a simple bounty box. What up, Beglov? Yeah, it is. It's a crazy idea. What's up, Jonah 19? High five. I'm working on the art for the Steam page right now. So I got this copy of the Steam page right here. And I'm just working on putting in some bits of art inside the text. So yeah, so this is ready to go. Really, I'm still trying to freaking officially publish this alpha version with good art, updating all the marketing pages. And so I've been working on this for days. JFK, what's up? Yeah, so I'm really looking forward to finishing this, and I'm excited to get it done. So then I can work on other stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna work on I'm getting not that image. Need that. I'm working on this image now. All right, so I think what the problem is this guy. So maybe we'll redraw these gradients. Think I'm gonna stick to these kind of gradients for this one. Yeah, I don't know. This might not work. Yeah, I don't think this works. That's probably just the best we're gonna get for now. Some stars. Maybe I can turn this way down. So that's kind of cool. A little bit of glow. Yeah, well, yep, this is what I'm doing. I've set aside a whole week. I think it will be a full week, yeah, this Wednesday that I've been just doing marketing. So yeah. Yeah, I agree. I agree. And so and the way this is working is I'm doing a week-long marketing push with every release. So like alpha ver this is the alpha version. There was also an older alpha version. There was also the Kickstarter, and the Kickstarter was like a whole 6 weeks of marketing. But the alpha version was only a week of marketing, and now this one's only a week of marketing, and then the beta version will be another week. And so in total, if you look at this whole project, out of a year of development, I'd say like two and a half to three, even 3 months are entirely just marketing. You know? It takes a lot of time. But what's great when you're doing these kind of marketing things, you end up creating some really cool art and stuff, and sometimes it creates great ideas for the game as well. So it's not all marketing. It's not all just creating mock-up images and stuff like that. There, now we got a nice little fade going with those stars. Okay, cool. I think this is ready to go. We'll try this out with the ship. See how big we can get it. Hey, what's up with that? I guess it has a little bit of a background. Oh, we don't want to be JPEG. We want to just be ping. 840? No. No. Oh, this is 840. Okay, we want to be 616. And cool, let's put this in the HTML and try it out. Maybe there. Let's do that right. Scene five. It's kind of cool. Kind of like seeing the ship like that. Looks pretty good. Okay, yeah, so I could put that with the story. I don't have a picture of the leaderboard yet, so I can't really show that. I should show something for secrets. Oh, in item crafting, I can show one of the cool items. Like the fire blink actually would be pretty sweet to see. Yeah, let's do a cool shot with the fire blink. So kind of in the same style where it's all blue in the background and the focus is on the character, I'm gonna do him teleporting over some kind of gap. Maybe there's the gate. Maybe it's gate two. That might be a good start there. Oh yeah. That's a cool idea. Cool. Thank you, man. Yeah. I like that. I could use some columns. Oh, you get the lightning sword. You get lightning and you get and the ghost sword. Did you try that? Did you try the lightning plus the ghost sword? Ah, cool. All right. Oh, yeah, shallow water. Cool, man. Nice. Yeah. Cool idea. That's sort of sword and sorcery. I like it. I kind of wish this was in the middle here, but oh well. Can make this work. Let's get rid of that. Got even on each side. Hey, what up, Wissiso? How you doing today, man? Oh, damn. Managers. Dude, when I worked at this one, I worked at a T-Mobile when I was much younger. And my manager was such an asshole. If I was like 3 minutes late, he was on me like a dog on a bone. He would lay into me every time I came into work. Oh, you're 3 minutes late again. Weiss, whatever he called me. It's kind of hilarious. It's so hilarious looking back at it now. You know, I'm like, I can't believe someone would disrespect me that much. It's funny how much like how lame it was. And what was funny is the guy was a lot younger than I was. He's like 5 years younger than me. So it felt even worse. I'm sure some of y'all out there have been able to relate to that. Having a boss that's younger than you and that yells at you. Just funny thinking about it now. So I'm just selecting all the pixels for this fire animation because I'm going to bring this to the foreground. Oops. Oops. Nice. Right on, man. Cool. In your thesis? Rad. Oh, yeah. At least she's nice. That's cool. Yeah, right. I mean, what does it hurt to be nice? My boss could have been nice about saying, "Hey, look, dude, you've been late a little bit every day. So why don't you get your acting gear?" But no. But oh it's perfect. It's perfect. All right, cool. Now we got that. We can kind of like lower the background a little bit, first of all. And now we can do some other stuff to blend it better. So put a gradient back here. Start with, I think I'm gonna try this gradient here. Something like this. A little more. Yeah, and then some regular gradients here on the edges. I'm thinking maybe another frame or two can go in here, actually. Like this frame might be cool. Yeah, so anybody who's just joining the stream, I'm working on marketing art today. Just drawing some graphics that are going to go on the Steam page. I've been pushing to get this marketing done for about a week now because I'm basically promoting the alpha version that just came out. So this is a one-man project. So I kind of have to do everything myself, including marketing and music and sound and programming. And so I'm just doing the best I can. I don't really know. I didn't go to marketing school or anything. I'm just doing whatever I can to just share the game and make it, kind of make it fun too. I want to make it fun for myself. So that's why I'm doing some cool graphics and trying to do some really interesting stuff to make a cool page. Yeah, Wissa Soad got you on there in the answer. What's up, Tana Kai? This is I use Photoshop for making the graphics. I use Audition for making sound effects, Ableton for music, and what I actually write the game in is Xcode, but that the engine I'm actually using is Cocos 2D X. It's different than Cocos 2D. It's a free open source engine. About that. How about that? And actually, let's just grab the other frame straight from the graphic for this. So, Rock, the hero, is fire blink, fire teleport, or fire blink sword, zero east. I think zero is what we want. Yeah. Here we go. So what frame do we want? Yeah, this one would be pretty cool. See, we're getting a little bit of. Almost needs to be lighter to kind of go with the levels. So let's do some levels on it. Bringing down the white point so it's a little brighter. But also want to wash it out more and take away some of its contrast. Just a little like that. What's up, Vlad? Welcome, man. Working on the Steam art stuff for the Steam page. Yeah, just like about like that. Nice. There we go. Yeah, so this kind of really illustrates the effect. This will be a nice thing to put here. Because I don't want to do animated GIFs for this little section. I just want to do some nice static GIFs, static images to kind of go in this text here. Things are great, man. Yeah. Yep. I actually took a nice day off yesterday. Sunday, kind of had to do some work on the house here. So yeah, but it's really nice to kind of just be taking to this week easy, just finishing this marketing stuff. Man, that just doesn't quite match. Oh, it's bugging me. It's bugging me. It's bugging me too much. All right, I'm gonna do the actual image. So, not that one. Oh, it doesn't have that one image. Oh, well, okay, I guess I do need to do it like this. Yeah, I like this image. Let's try it out. Okay, I'm gonna export. These are all 616 or so. And let's add it to the HTML somewhere. Around the items, probably. Oh, whoops. Not supposed to export that. There we go. Just this. I think you kind of get the point that he's warping over something there. It's got that little barricade or whatever. I think this is actually pretty good. See if partner Steam games has just been down. Oh, still down. I wish I could get it the latest text and stuff. Because I'm ready for that right now. I could totally put this online and show you guys the link and everything. But Steam's down. Steam is down. I think this is good enough. This is good enough images. I might do one more. Yeah, let me just do one more as sort of optional last image, and maybe it'll be there, maybe it won't. I could play with it later. I was thinking getting your psychedelic powers would be pretty cool. But also, yeah, oh, let's do that suggestion. Who mentioned it? Oh yeah. Pedro, yeah, let me try doing the healing shrine thing. Refill. The only problem is this is kind of zoomed in, but that's all right. That one. Okay, let's see what we can make of this one. For this image, you kind of need all this. Most of this visible. Maybe not this last bit of this rock up here. But at least like that much. Sweet, cool. You're building a prototype for university? Are you working as part of a team or are you working solo? So this is the only problem with this image is it's zoomed in, so it's really kind of janky. See, that's supposed to be one pixel. That is one pixel right there. So some of these pixels are one, some of them are two. Solo? Oh, sad face. Oh. I don't know if this is gonna look that good, actually. I can try though. Can always try. Because the game is zoomed in. When I took that screenshot, the game was zoomed in. Because it like zooms in when you go to the refill. Nice, right on, yay! That's right. You need any help? You know exactly where to ask. Yeah, but I'd have to re-record the scene. I guess I could do that. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Right? Cool. All right, let's do it. So we'll get. So this is what's so great about the way I did these screenshots. I saved the text file for the save game for every one of these shots, so I can pretty much easily go back to that same place. Oh, see, I forgot refill though. Damn. All right, so I got to run it once and figure out where the refill is, and we'll go to one of them. Okay, here's a refill and there's a refill. Oh, this is probably the one I was at before. Let's try this one. 7, 6, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 4. Halo thingy. You mean this the light beam? Okay, let's see if that's the right place, and then we'll try. I might need to try that other one. What up, Alex Pita? Why didn't I? Oh, 5, 4, 0. BC Warrior. Yeah, sounds cool. Like it here. I like it here. Right, we got to start with some hurt. Boogie, what's that? So we'll set initial hurt of 2.0. It's all right. It's all right. Okay, so now I gotta get it to not zoom. Let's try it again. Oh, dude, you're so off today. So off. Ugh. That actually is pretty cool. I gotta add to this ideas. By the way, I'm thinking about making. All right, we'll do it later. I'm thinking about making the whole ideas list a GitHub repo. So every one of these ideas would be an issue on GitHub, and I could assign some to my next milestone or whatever. So you guys would know what I'm working on and stuff, and it would be kind of a lot more public. And all these bugs also would be online. So if anybody's sharing bugs, they like you just like all you guys that just played the alpha version, you'd at least have been able to go on there and be like, oh, that one's already listed, that one's already listed. I don't know if that's a smart idea or not, though. So I'm kind of throwing that out there right now. See what you guys think. No banning. BC head. Okay, not no zooming. Let's see. Yeah, you think so? Cool. Yeah. There might be a better way to do it too than a GitHub repo. I was just thinking GitHub repo would probably be pretty organized, you know. That way I can kind of like I can acknowledge all your suggestions and stuff like that, and also bug reports, and I can also assign them to a milestone, and they're public, you know. And all the ideas could be there too. So if anybody wants to share an idea, you can go on there and see if that idea has already been shared. Or you can expand on somebody else's idea by commenting, you know? So it's the phase walk to. Oh, no wonder it's such a crazy angle, because that was 1.618 rather than like 1.5 or whatever. Yeah, track also might be a better way to do that. 'Cause chat or track, you're gonna actually assign a priority, right, to each task or whatever. So I haven't used track in so many years, so I don't know, has it improved lately or? Cool. Okay. You know, the other suggestion that was I know, right? This game's a tiny window, because it's saving a ping file every single tick, and I want these ping files to be raw, you know, like totally the smallest resolution that the game runs at. Nice, right on. So right, the previous suggestion was using Trello, but I think Trello doesn't does it, I don't think Trello has priorities and milestones and other kinds of important project management-y things. There, that's a good shot right there. This could work out good. Game Boy Advance version. Yeah, it totally was, right? It's the Game Boy Advance version. Yeah, I was thinking that too, right? It's just messy, not really. Yeah, the most important thing to me, you know, to you guys, it's cool that it's becoming public, right? And so, you know, that way you can comment on other people's ideas or bugs or whatever. But to me, what's the most important thing is being able to assign a priority. You know, I need to be able to assign like, okay, this is like a cool idea, but it's not immediately important right now, so I can assign it a priority of one or whatever. And then ideas that are really important to get done right now, it's like, super important can be like a priority three or whatever. Okay. Yeah, a green mode would be sweet.
We're still going to be playing some games tonight.
It's so great. I'm gonna watch all this later. It's the BC Warrior himself. Oh, it's so awesome. Oh, okay. Channel 19. I'm trying for it. We got it? Oh, look at that. Look at that. It was fast. Fast. Whoa. Super duper. We got a long ways to go, guys. Just making it fair there. I don't know. Could happen. Could happen. Yeah, this is gonna make a cool scene here. Oh, dang. What's this? Oh. Flip. Okay, what's this? Free lossless image format? Oh, wow. Wow, that sounds great. But does it. How. What is a. Pandemonium! Okay, cool. Works on any kind of image? Oh, right. Any type of image, like a picture versus a. That sounds great, but is if there's no browsers using it, I mean, this is so cool for the future, and we'd really need something like this, you know? Oh, for the game? Yeah. For the game, yeah. That's it. But I don't know, I can see this being a really, really great application for web games or web, the web in general. Really, it's not really gonna help the game that much right now because it's already using PBR and some other great compressed texture formats and stuff. So it's cool, but it wouldn't be, it's not really something important enough to implement at this point in this game, because it's an offline game, it's not really an online game at all. Yeah. It's cool. I'm so glad to see this though, finally. I heard the WebP was actually better, in some browsers can use WebP, but that sounds like it's even better than WebP. We definitely need this, and I bet you Google's excited about it if it's gotten to them yet. Okay, I'm gonna have to isolate all these characters individually. None of these are exactly the same color, so it's really, really hard to get it. Use the magic wand in this case. Cool. Ah. Yeah. Pixels, yay, pixels. I freaking love pixels. I probably always will. Just love that style. Let's cut this to a new layer. Yeah, that's another great reason to do a GitHub repo, right? Is that I can add more readmes and pages for information for, like, if there is, you know, if one day there's a modding community for this, maybe a hobbyist style modding community, you can make your own adventure or whatever with all your own story and characters and everything with using the songbringer.exe or whatever. It would be sweet to have some kind of like programming doc about how to make mods. Pixels. They're important. Yeah, me too. I'm so glad. Yeah. That's kind of why I lost my whole interest in making games in the 2000s. I was like, man, everything's 3D. Nothing's like it was when I was a kid. I don't really like 3D games as much. I don't really like... I mean, I guess I liked making 3D games. They're okay. But I much prefer to make old school pixel games. And then this whole resurgence of pixel art and retro games just gave me the confidence that, dude, I want to get in on this. I want to make pixel art games. I'm glad. I mean, I wish I would have had the courage when I was younger to just make pixel art games, even though they weren't popular for a good decade or whatever. You know? Because I would be so much farther on this road. But you live and learn. You know, I had to go through that phase, I guess, to learn that I really love pixel art. True. True. Doesn't necessarily mean simpler. Yeah, Peter. Well said. Yeah, I'm definitely not saying 3D is bad. And in fact, I still enjoy 3D games. It's just that I enjoy pixel art more and the old gameplay of 2D games. I really appreciate. I guess I prefer, but that doesn't mean I don't enjoy 3D games and like them, you know. Wow, this is an ag algorithm. Know, would it? This is so crazy. Depixelizing pixel art. The new one, The Witness, or is this a newer one? Yeah. Right, almost done. Yeah, those are cool, right? Wait a minute. Oh, because that pillar is so. I guess I might want to actually. Oh, the witness, yeah. Cool. Yeah, so I think I do want to take these background bits, or the part that's on glowing, and I'll actually reuse the sprites, the original sprites for those. Loading, here we go. Yeah, it is. Yeah, that's what that's. It's making a lot of noise right now. You would think that just selecting some pixels in Photoshop wouldn't be that hard of a CPU task, but Photoshop is horrible at some things. Selecting pixels is one of them. It's like really inefficient. But I do have the older version, so maybe this is like, maybe they fixed this in a newer version or whatever. Yeah. Doc, what's up, Doc? Yo, man, I haven't seen you in a minute. Hope things have gotten a little smoother for you, man. Yeah, of course. Of course, I could do that. Any kind of shader, no problem. Don't call me wizard for nothing. Ooh, yeah, you just finished the important part of your game. Yeah, sweet, Eklof. Oh, took ages, right? What up, Duty Ba? Welcome all y'alls. I'm working on the art for the Steam page. It's coming along. I got a few different images that are here are gonna be on the Steam page. And I'm working on one last one. And yeah, and then later on tonight I'll be making the text and everything better. And then finally tomorrow I'll post an announcement about the alpha here on the Steam page and also post an announcement on Kickstarter and also send it to a lot of people. Yeah, getting there? Cool, man. Yeah, oh, dude, it's going good, man. Everything's great. Everything's great. The alpha version got released last week. There's a new video. And I'm working on the Steam page, so this is kind of, I'm working on this page right here. This is kind of, you're seeing the older version because I can't publish right now. There's an error trying to log in to Steamworks or whatever. So I'm just editing on my local desktop a copy of the HTML from Steam so I can just add some images and get this all ready. So because this is the most time-consuming part, is adding these images and also writing, writing all this text and updating it. So I kind of this morning I did a real update of all the text on this page from and it's not here on this example I'm showing you because Steamworks it just died for a while. But anyways, yeah, so I'll just work on images and stuff and then later it'll be ready to go. How's the weather been, Doc? Think I'm looking for background refill. Refill pillar 01. It's winter. Oh man. That's crazy. It's winter already. The best way to pre-order is just from the Humble Bundle directly from songbringer.com. That just goes yeah, I mean, Humble Bundle takes their percentage cut if only if you order from the Humble Bundle store. So if you actually order from songbringer.com, more of your dollars goes in goes into actually developing the game. So yeah. Thanks, man. And that's also the best deal for you guys too, because the game's $16 now, and it'll be probably a few bucks more when it comes out. And you get your name on the main menu, which is cool if you like that. Okay, so we just need to darken these a lot to go with that other pillar. All right, that looks okay. Now I just want to add that glowing bit. Awesome, man. Cool. Yeah. I mean, it's a lot better than the last version. It's a lot more playable. There's a lot more world to explore. There's more enemies and stuff. But man, my head's already in the next version. I'm like, I can't wait to get the freaking beta out because the beta is gonna have a lot of cool stuff. Levels are gonna get a lot more interesting. Items are gonna be more tied to the levels. So for a few of the dungeons. So a few of the dungeons will have this sort of what am I trying to say here? A few of the dungeons will be sort of story based. And then a few of the dungeons will be sort of optional secret dungeons. And then lastly, a few of the dungeons will be kind of these like big old boss, like incredibly difficult. The last three are gonna be really difficult. Three of them are gonna be secret, sort of hidden or optional. And then three of them, they're gonna be really tied to the story and the item that you get in it is gonna be it's gonna be themed dungeons. These are really, really themed dungeons. So a lot of artwork is gonna go into three of the dungeons, basically. Three of the dungeons are gonna be kind of more psychedelic, I'm thinking. It's, you might even be in dreamland or something like that. Like I'm thinking you find this fountain, and if you have a cup, which is a separate item you find somewhere else in the game, you find this cup, and that allows you to get to open up three dungeons if you have the cup. It's like, right? It seems like a stupid item, the cup, but really it's a very important item, and it unlocks three dungeons. And so that you drink from this fountain, and then it puts you into this super crazy dream trippy state. Where you're just dreaming, but you meet your spirit guide, this character who is on the poster, the guy with the horns. He's gonna be your spirit guide, and you actually train with him and get abilities. So it's kind of a different style of dungeon. Oh, I take a lot of for making sound effects. I use a lot of stuff from freesound.org, and then I just play with it. I open it in Audition, shorten it, stretch it, you know. Cut parts out, mix it with other stuff. Sometimes I'll actually go in and put it all the way into Ableton and apply other effects and maybe synthesize some other noises that go with it. It all depends on the sound effect. But for that locking sound for dungeon doors, I just found that on freesound.org mostly. I don't think I really edited that one much. Nice. So thank you, man. Thank you for pre-ordering. Every pre-order goes towards making the game better. Before it first comes out, I prefer to have like a good 6 months if possible from now. So that would mean releasing in March. That's my preferred release date. But I have the funds right now for releasing in January. So yeah. So thank you, man. Every little bit counts. There. Okay, now we got. Wait, what happened to. Oh. Everyone want that too. Yay! Okay, this is kind of getting there now. Now I want the background that's fading out to have a fade of sort of a fade effect going on. Thanks, man. Cool. Awesome. So, yeah, I'm gonna do a layer mask. Yeah. And let's do a gradient. Yeah, she is always keeping me on the straight and narrow. She's doing great. Yep. Doing awesome. Did you hear we got engaged? I don't know if you were on the stream when I was kind of announcing that or whatever back in July or early August or whatever. But yeah, we got engaged on our vacation, and so she'll be officially Mrs. Fu. Yeah, sort of like that. And then let's combine these. Oh, cool. All right. Yeah. Isn't that awesome? Oh, Marza, you weren't there. Yeah, okay, yeah. Yep. My girl and I got engaged by a waterfall. It was a great moment. It was really cool. Yeah. And just so happens somebody else was by this waterfall right then, and they took a picture of us. So we have this picture we can share with each other. It's pretty cool. Do I wear a pink wig? Yeah, it's for real. Yeah, I did say it on, probably only said it on like one stream or whatever. Yeah, that's probably why it's not a secret. Yeah, it's pretty cool to be with someone that's just like exactly who you need to be with, you know? What up, Grim Gary? Wear a pink wig. Yeah. Oh, I've said it multiple times? Oh. Okay. I don't remember everything I say. Thankfully, I have the ability to forget. I think that's actually a really important ability. It's a power. It's a power to forget. I learned that if we didn't have the power to forget, we wouldn't be able to learn new stuff, which would be a tragedy. An absolute travesty. Okay, let's check this one out. This one's done. Yeah. All right. Yeah, right. Cool. All right, so let's see how this looks. Throw in this sixth image. See how it flows. Yes. Did I? Everyone in the chat. All right. Why not? Hey, but this is the end. Something like that. Okay, so this one needs to be kind of thinking smaller, wider, and fade outier. Whoa, you got engaged in a thunderstorm on a volcano? Oh, wow, dude, this is the most epic engagement ever. Wow, Doc, seriously. Dang, man, that's a freaking awesome. That's a story for sure. Yeah, totally badass. Screenshot or it didn't happen. Yeah, that's that. I would agree. So now that we have more of this image, we might as well use more of it. I'm thinking this should be a little bit smaller, maybe like 420. Yeah, that's pretty good. And then some, a little more of this background would really help this flow better. Yeah. Yeah, why not? A jib the witness. Oh man, if I could, dude, if I could build a little flying robot friend, I would. Oh my gosh, you guys, I wrote part of the story and stuff last night. Oh, I'm so, I don't want to tell anybody because I don't want to give it away. It's, spoiler alert type thing, but seriously, I'm really excited to finally put all the story in. It's gonna be cool. Yeah, Game Boy colors too. All green. Oh yeah, it's pretty multiplayer friendly, because I started it from the very beginning with multiplayer in mind. It was kind of a possibility in my mind. So, I designed ticks separate from animation calls, and everything is using integers already instead of floats. So those two things really help to make a cross-platform multiplayer real-time game. But I'll tell you the truth. I've already done multiplayer games, real-time multiplayer games, and it would probably take a whole nother year just to get it to be multiplayer. It's a hell of a lot of work. So it's very unlikely that Songbringer, the first Songbringer at least, will be multiplayer. I'm thinking maybe down the road, like Songbringer 2 or 3 might be multiplayer. But it's, of course, it's going to be local multiplayer with the co-op play and all that. Yeah, totally. Is it? Okay. I think it might be one of the letters I need to get in there. Yeah. It's definitely not easy. I mean, it's kind of set up that way. The engine would be friendly for it. It's just that it doesn't matter how friendly your engine is or how great your library is. Just debugging multiplayer code itself can take a whole year. There we go. We'll get those in there. The A with the circle on top. What's that called? What's that called? What is your word for that, Eklof? I'm calling it the A with the circle on top, though. Man, I'm such an American sometimes. It's just an A with the circle on top. There we go. That's prettier. We can see the background. That makes it so the pillars aren't as actually the pillars need to be a little more transparent. Yeah, like that. Nice. Now they're kind of like popping out a little, but not too much. Good. This is gonna be even better. What is it called? Ooh? Am I saying that right? Ooh? I'm always interested in languages and, cultural differences and stuff. I guess because I traveled earlier on in life and stuff. It's nice to be not myopic. People, I think especially here in my country, can be myopic in the sense that I'm not talking about everybody or you guys or anything. I'm just saying that it's like the average person in my country only cares about what's going on maybe in their city or maybe their state, but it's not like they care too much about what's going on across the world. What the heck am I looking for? Yeah, when we get married? I don't know. We haven't actually set a date yet, so we're like, we're in the process of setting those plans. So I'll let you guys know though. Mars will probably send some bread. Like, yes, bread. A good question. Does the actual circle on top have a specific name? So it's called a sedia. Sedia. Is that right? Am I saying that right? Or is it Sedisha? No, that would be like the Argentine way of saying it. Coming. It's already on the way. Yeah, come crash. Ah. Love a punk wedding. Yeah, that's actually turned out pretty good. I like that. Cool. And what's great about these images, all of these images, is that they're. They're just ready to go for putting on any website, any background. I need a couple of bread rings. What are those? Are those for making bread? Nice idea. All right, I think this is pretty good. Let's see if, come on, Steamworks, what's wrong with you? Oh, there it goes. It's logged in. Okay, so I can log in real quick. Diet critical. Whoa. Okay, so my screen's gonna go black here for a second because I'm gonna go log in. I can't show this to you guys because it's freaking under confidentiality agreement or whatever. So I'm gonna log into the Steamworks account really quick and upload these images. And update the text and then publish it so you guys can see it too. No, it's not down. It's not down. I just said it shouldn't be down. Yeah. So it's black on purpose. Yep. What? Oh, it's still having problems. Well, okay, I guess I can't do this right now. Valve's website is messed up today. Super messed up. Oh well. Okay, I'll go back into not black mode. Oh, Steam. Yes. It is the confidential part of the Steam. Okay, there, we're back. Well, okay, so I couldn't go on to Steam and update the page because their site's still broken right now. It's like giving all these errors and stuff. Oh, yeah. Enhance. I always laugh at that, the digital enhancement or whatever, where they zoom in so much past the pixels and stuff, and all of a sudden they have a freaking image. So great. Well, that's pretty much all I wanted to do for today was create these graphics. And now that they're created, I really want to show you guys and put it on the website, but I can't right now. So, what's up, Late Bird? I don't know what else to do today. This is really my only plan. All I want to do for the rest of the day is get this up on Steam and write an announcement thing so I can have some an announcement ready to go for tomorrow. How long has the stream been so far? Oh, it's been 2 hours anyways. All right. Well, yeah. So yeah, that's it for today's stream then. 2 hours. Oh, yeah. This is far more important than anything else that's been done today. That's right. If anybody's watching this stream, you know what to do. It's easy. Oh. No, I've never done this. I've never tracked an IP address at all in Visual Basic. Oh, we're getting so many fails. Oh. Let's try it one more time. One more time. Come on. One more time. Don't, wait, maybe we just do fail fish. Fail fish. Yes. Adaptation. You guys are so smart. Fail fish. Oh, freaking bot. Oh, dude. For like, this is the worst bot ever. Are we cursed today? Watch the video? All right.
Fascination.
This is in real time. I'll create a GUI interface using Visual Basic. See if I can track an IP address.
I'll just go create an interface with Visual Basic. That's so great. So great. Yes. You guys are hilarious. All right, so yeah, it's dinner time for me. I'm gonna go get some dinner. I'll be uploading this later though. So if anybody's following along, tomorrow will be, I don't know what tomorrow will be, but it'll be something. Totally combo breaking bot. Worst bot ever. So I had fun with you guys today, and we'll see you next time.